Well, that break seemed to last at no time whatsoever. The Cold Wars just keep on going, so they're a player behind. We're going to see a gank up on the top lane. Cinderin's going to have a crack at that one, and a pretty decent crack at that. Miran's actually the one that gets the last hit. Already on the way back out again. Big Lich Ultimate's going to bounce around inside that creep wave, as well as onto the heroes. AA's already gone. And it's going to be the Urn Charge that kills off Windrunner, and then the Anchor Smash to kill off the Vengeful Spirit. So Miranda was a casualty of that war, but three heroes going down for the dive for the one-off trade. Gotta love how the delays don't even keep on going. And I'm just going to double-check my VOD as well. Yeah, it is working again. So now 7-2 is where we're going to sit. Hitting over 5,000, heading towards the 7.5 grand advantage. 11 minutes in. Dyer's middle tower. So, Cinderin just answering one of the queries of the captain of GDT. Passes in question. It's like, no reason. I'm cool, man. I'm cool. So, in the meantime, 7-2. Three kills each for Peppy. There goes our mid tower. Sea Badger really pushing hard. A lot of farm for him. Mech as well as face boots. 11 minutes in. And still has an extra 1,000 gold to spare. 77 for 17. Has died once, which is why there's actually not as much gold as what his CS should indicate. This still has a lot of money. Might even see the pipe come up on him a little bit sooner with the amount of farm he's actually getting. Help out the team in multiple ways. Once that pipe is up too, Ancient Apparition will basically feel very, very useless. Especially, well, considering AA is actually not level 6 yet. Cinderin comes down, picks up the DD rune. No bottle charge for Sin, so he's not wanting to run that way. It's just simple Urn boots. Have himself the mask and then get himself towards that Yule Scepter. No need to actually have a bottle if you're going to go Yules. And a great play as well with Lich going up high. The slow goes, double slow with Cinderin going in as well. But it's a bit of a sandwich kind of effect. Ulti coming of cooldown, that's what I'm talking about during that nighttime. In the meantime, Vengeful Spirit getting blasted. Nether Ward has actually dropped, so VS can't stun right now. And Cinderin with a silence as well as hit. Taku also now getting silenced. Good shackle shot, at least from Windrunner. We still don't have Crown One back, so it is technically a 4v5 right now. Dire's top tower is under attack. And there goes our power shot. We've got flying down towards the bottom lane, a little bit of goodies. So Hand of Midas from Mirana. Not the first time I've actually seen this build coming out from WHP. It's a bit of a random build when people look at it, just going, hang on, why the hell is there a Hand of Midas? But it really actually helps for the one, attack speed, and two, the extra 190 in XP. So you get double the XP from whatever creep you cast the Hand of Midas on. It's an instant kill, so great when you're actually trying to farm and you get a big ass creep, which just really delays your farming transition. Cinderin takes the top with the help of Lich. But the Hand of Midas, and also helps get a lot faster on towards that Yasha. In the meantime, it's the Netherworld from Pugna, which actually kills off Windrunner. She tried to pop off the Windrunner ability, didn't have enough life to survive it though. And Pugna's blast not going to be enough. Mirana tries to leap up, there's extra speed. Taku with ball charges, 10 HP still living. And Tullers goes in, Beastmaster Roar. Pugna's being held down, Tullers also with a stun. Lich Ultimate's going to bounce down through the creep wave. It does get the kill on the Vengeful Spirit, massive overkill. But it does make it to 11-2. Wild Honey Badger's already having a great start to this tournament. They really need to win a lot of these games in this early stage. They were lucky enough to win the game early today up against Meet Your Makers. And now GDT, they're in a good position against them. And in a group when you've got not only... You've basically got a lot of the top teams of this competition. SK Gaming, Global Domination Times also win here. We've got Roots, which is the new French order. They've now changed their name. Oh, sorry, Fail Micro. Problems are the old Meteor Makers and then the new Meteor Makers. All in the one pool. Makes life a little bit harder. And only the top three teams were able to actually transition. TP up towards the top. Should be coming sometime soon. Tower should be able to deal with it, though. And Cinderin goes back towards the bottom lane. So we're into our next daytime cycle. And already having the Yule Scepter. Is already completed, just waiting for the courier to get back towards the main base, then he'll pick it up. Bottle is actually being run as well. So Cinderin already with the Yules as we hit into the second daytime cycle. And he's already level 11. A lot of farmers, a lot of levels for a Night Stalker. 6 kills, no deaths, 3 assists, 50 for 13. 3 for 1 for Pepe, 65 for 15. And then you look down towards GDT, the only 2 kills for their team so far have both gone to the Vengeful Spirit. So it's the support hero getting Andy Majors and the one doing it. Now they want to go from the bottom lane. Swap to start, stun as well. They know the daytime is the time to shine. Oh no! Oh! Stunned! And the courier died from Taku's roar! Oh my lord, the Yule Scepter is gone! It didn't. Oh no, it transferred! It transferred. The bottle was left on it. I was thinking, why didn't I see the Yule Scepter on the bottom lane? But that is insanely lucky for Sindarin not to have actually lost the Yule Scepter. If he lost the Yules, he'll be spitting chips right now. That would have been about 2,000 gold, not to mention the 400 gold they put in for the courier. In the meantime, Tito Tower go down top lane. Badger will just throw our blast and we'll get the kill. There we go. More money for the partner. He's even picked up a Yules. Yules is just like the item here for WHP. They're all about honoring the original creator of the game type of Dota. A Yule. Pepe gonna throw an arrow out. Too close though. Leaps away, gets out of range, and now the Yule Scepter will send Anti-Mage up in the air. Can't need to actually combo that Yules as well as the arrow. Then life can be better for him. But that bottle was lost. As well as the courier, so extra money will have to be spent. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Not to mention the amount of money you get, the amount of money you lose sending one hero back to the main base. So you can't build, you can buy a courier, as well as a flying courier, while you're out in the lane, but you can't actually activate it. So you need to send somebody back. And at this point, I don't think anybody from Wild Honey Badgers wants to go back. There's too many towers to push down. They've already taken down all the tier ones, and only one tier two tower remains, and it's sitting at basically full life on that bottom lane. So the Greater Hawk will fly out. Does catch a very, very quick glimpse. Taku gets decrypified for a moment. Let's just see Badger's way of saying hello. And nice Stalker getting that farm. He's halfway through the daytime cycle. Mirage taking a lot of damage. Take me. Vengeful Spirit once again stealing that last hit. I'll be really careful how many of these Vengeful Spirit actually takes. These kills have to go to Taku. Taku, Windrunner, even Ancient Apparition. Windrunner needs that 4 staff up. Taku needs something. Illusion. Treads and 2 gauntlets, there's nothing. Now they want to go in the bottom lane on Sindarin again. An Anti-Mage up on the top, at least has a Vanguard. 18 minutes in, Vanguard and Treads. But knows he'll be pushed back pretty hard, so just TPing himself back out again. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane. I saw a crow fly off randomly. I'm just like, what the hell? That was supposed to be there. Yeah, there it is. It's dead. I don't know if I was the only one with a graphics glitch. Either that or my eyes are glitching. Either can work. Now, Sindarin's having fun on the bottom lane. So I also want to point out, too, that like the courier can actually be stunned by Beastmaster's Roar. Just generally the damage is actually not done to it. That's the reason why people are actually talking about it. But because it was originally cast on Nightstalker, the damage was then still spread out behind him. And that's where that's where it actually came from. That's why the courier died. There was no shield. So really, you can't, Wild Honey Badgers have kind of got to accept the fact they should have actually activated the shield before the courier went in. Or Sindarin just shouldn't have sent him. Now Sindarin goes into the glitch to actually buy. Actually, it does work, so he has got away. Shackle shot doesn't actually latch onto anything, because there is nothing there for it to latch to. The courier goes down. Arrow will fly. Windrunner gets hit. Vengeful Spirit stun as she follows Pepe through the leap. Yule Scepter throws Beastmaster up in towards the air. He doesn't have his roar, I don't believe. No, he does not. Actually, yes, he does. He's just currently silent, so he can't cast it right now. Taku's in trouble. Earn charges on top of him. They need to get one more hit. The gush will be it. And the Pugna Blast gets the hit just before the axe is going to fly. And Sindarin catches the Windrunner. Good shackle shot. Holding Sindarin to that tree. And then Syndrome with a simple void. It was at that point Windrunner basically had to accept the fact she was going to die. Probably should try to get herself denied by the Ursa Warrior. Simple clap. Should have been enough damage. And because now there's a big opening, I'll head down towards the Roshan pit and kill it off. It's interesting to see Peppy with not much items-wise. Like Ring of Basilis is on there, but and not much gold as well. Nothing's in the stash. 3 for 2. Well, that just an extra death which set him back, and he hasn't completed up his Yasha just yet. Trying to kill off Roshan, so earn charges if they need to. Syndrome's already using it. And Sea Badger is causing issues on the bottom lane. Blast just a little bit too short from that tower, as well as the heroes. So four's up. The Greater Hawk comes up as well, so it might have a little bit of a search down towards Roshan. Vengeful Spirit gets the stun on Sea Badger. Getting cold feeded up, but they didn't get that chain off. But the VS brings him back. Arrow will fly up. Instant stun on Windrunner. And we do see the ultimate with a blink dagger from Titan, ensuring it actually hitting the right spot. Seabed's going to be a little bit too careful going in close. Ventral Spirit will take a fall, retreating back out again. Taku goes down. Cinderum with himself a double kill. And Ty just diving past the tower to kill down Yellow. But Wild Honey Badgers did retreat out of that at the right time. And they realize that, that Roshan, he can wait. They got to get themselves a couple of kills. Tier 1 tower to go down the top. Anti-mage farming up what appears to be almost a complete Battle Fury. He's about 1,600 gold short of it, but he'll have it then. If they do get later on in this game, then Anti-mage can out carry. But 16 to 4 and you've lost all your towers bar 1. Outside your main base, it's not a good position to be in. And way too sexy to having a good time on top. Might force a TP. I think that's actually what he wants to do. Really needs to claim this tower. Really needs to claim it if he can. There's a TP. Can deal enough damage to this tower to actually kill it. Tide comes in. Tide will not be enough to actually stop the anti-mage. It's dropping down his damage output and his force to blink away. Will actually have a deny of the tower on top. If he can get the timing right. And he gets it too. So tower is denied. And the tier 2 tower on the bottom lane is actually also within the 9 range. They've got to be careful doing it. See Badger with one blast can kill that. They need to deny this tower. Stun now on Sea Badger. Nightstalker is in there. Beastmaster Roar goes, holding the Pugna in place. Arrow flies in. A long arrow onto Taku. Starfall, Pugna blast. And it's just death all round. Nightstalker gets himself a double. There's all distractions with the Mirana as well as Pugna. Send Anti-Mage up in the air. They pull him out. The tower is killed by Cinnarin as well. Give him a triple kill. And he's going to make it a quad kill if he kills off Tullis. The drain actually from Pugna. This is what gets him the kill, but 4 heroes down for GDT. Anti-Mage is the only one to live, escaping back out again. He'll buy up that Claymore. And then the Broadsword will come after. Fortification now up. Try and slow down this push. Peppy has friends, basically himself. Actually, he doesn't have friends, he's not even there. Peppy's dead. Aeolus is going to hit pretty nicely. Anti-Mage will blink in. Good ultimate there on the Pugna. Nightstalker also forced back, realizing now with that power shot. Yeah, that option to fall below a certain point, which when Ancient Apparition's ulti would shatter him. But GDT successfully defend that base. So just a little bit too greedy there by WHB, thinking they can achieve that. And hello to Lich, who's just completed up a Hood of Defiance. So he is actually going to go for that pipe. That pipe of insights are expecting from Pugna. But they did the wise thing, and this is a... I know it's a big thing of Syndra, and he hates it when this happens. When you actually have... Well, Hacking Him Scepter already at 24 with everything he's got? Crap. don't like having pipe as well as mech on one hero. Shut down that one hero, you lose out in the pipe. Ancient Apparition's ulti will actually then do some damage. He at least has it now. At level 7. And nighttime Syndra's got that vision from the Aghanims. He can see that crow. He can see that hawk standing there, so they know there's that vision. And Syndrome won't just care about it. He'll head down towards the bottom lane. Anti-Mage is here. He's already used his blink. He'll be on cooldown. The fact that she's silenced now going to cause himself a little more trouble. And we'll just TP out, but the Yule Scepter cancels the TP. Tries to blink again. Pugna goes for the second Yule, goes for the blast. Good time to blink there from way too sexy. BK, the Beastmaster Roar. Shackle shot as well, but the Lich ultimate, there's no creep wave here. They have to split, but the boars Oh, Taku should not have created those the call of the Wild Descent. It gave the Legitima something more to actually bounce from. Now, Vengeful Spirit gets called out. Pugna Blast, he decrepified him so no one else could actually attack him. And then just blast away, and VS will die, or is dead. And now the Scythe of Vice is now completed as well on Pugna. So a lot of disable coming out. Ancient Apparition Order is going to hit pretty nicely here on WHP. The one mech charge later, and they'll have no issue with that. And there's 10 seconds away. And with three heroes down, even with the low cooldown for their respawn, it's not going to be enough to stop the Tier 3 tower dying on bot. The melee barracks will follow. And then the range will go from there. I think WHB are really trying to bring the fetish of the Yule Scepter back again. Maybe the boys from China might be watching this just going, hey, Yules and Cinderin, wow, just hit, stun, Pugna, blast, decrepify, as well as using the anti-mage. Sends him back up again, really just holding him out of this fight while they pick off his teammates. Decrepified again so he can't attack. Links up and Cinderin's there, but he can run away fast enough. So way too sexy. I think we have now found our answer to an anti-mage. Stop him from attacking by decrepifying the anti-mage and then double Yule Scepter. Send him up in the air, take him out of that fight. They can pick off the Ancient Apparition. They already got the bottom barracks and they're going to stick around to stay. So an option to think about in the future for a lot of teams out there. Yule Scepter sending the Vengeful Spirit up. I think VS was thinking about actually going for a swap. I did not want to allow that. It looks like in the meantime, Wild Hunting Badgers will push through the middle lane. Or at least keep the pressure on. The bottom lane has already got those Super Seismic Creeps running up there. And the bright side for GDT is we actually have that Battle Fury on Anti-Mage. Downside for him is he's going up against Pugna. Blinks further down south. Realize he can get ganked off if he goes up north. As that TP scroll, so in the end he just decides where's the safest place inside the opposition's jungle. Powershot trying to slow down the push in the mid. AA doesn't want to throw down that ultimate just to actually stop a push. He wants it to actually initiate. Powershot from Windrun, there goes our AA ulti. It's on nothing. There's no one really lined up in that middle. I think they're expecting Wild Honey Badgers to actually dive in then. But there was no real point. They couldn't damage the tower. Now the Piper will go. So the Axes do nothing. Beastmaster gets sent up. Gets turned into a piglet. Arrowed up. In comes the Blink from Tundunder with a good Ravage. Getting three of them that. Starfall as well. Hitting on top of the Ancient Apparition as well as the Vengeful Spirit. So the supports are gone. Anti-Mage is stuck on the bottom lane. He does have that TP if he wants to come back. Windrunner is now back in the game. But she is decrepified. Already actually with that Windrun popping off too. Getting a little bit of damage there from the Pugna Ward. But the mid will now go off, making life even harder. Mirana pops off the ultimate. So these heroes will pop in and out of Invis. And GDT set up their shoutouts. As the mid barracks goes down and the rotation will come towards the top. Either that or they go for the GG. AA ulti just niggling there on Pugna. He just spins himself up in the air so he doesn't get any more of the effect. Vengeful Spirit with a simple stun, but silence, decrepified, negative earn charge. Arrow's even going to fly again. It's going to hit Taiko at very, very long range. But they are going for the GG. So GDT will sit back in their main base and probably let this one just happen. That creep wave still hasn't made it in yet. The tier 4 tower goes down. Taiko is decrepified. Lets off the Beastmaster roar. With the pipe up though, it does no damage, just holds him in place just a little bit longer. And then the Lich Ultimate's going to bounce very, very hard inside. At least they share it among friends. Windrunner almost dying to that. Cinderin goes back to take care of the tier 4 tower. Turns around, silence, Yules goes up. And instantly Titan comes back in again. But the creep wave is up. AL is going to hit there on Cinderin. It's actually enough to kill him. With AM ulti. But Aegis the Immortal brings him back up again. And that means Jello's gonna die. Even with those bottle charges popping off, Cinderin needs one more void. And we'll actually probably dive to get it. No, need the void. We'll just take a lot of damage doing so. And Anti-Mage having fun in the middle lane. Looks like he's already picked up Tidehunter with the Decrepify. Now they'll chain off, actually 15 seconds cooldown on the Sheep Stick. That's the Ancient down half life. Cinder just yulzing the boys up. And now they're going to go for the GG. They've had enough. Pipe will pop, VS swapping. Got to be careful how much mana he actually uses. Arrow will fly as well. Tarkin manages to avoid that, but they can't fight within the ward. And Wild Honey Badgers will take this pretty convincingly. There's our official GG. So Wild Honey Badgers go up 2-0. It's to actually see how they use these strats and what like the strats up against like a team like SK Gaming, or when probably get to play their first match as well tomorrow. We'll see how they'll go up against these kind of strats from Wild Honey Badgers, and Wild Honey Badgers will then be pushed and tested. GDT just a little bit off their game tonight, had that problem with the disconnection too, so it's a little bit of a sad case for them with Windrunner unable to actually reconnect back into the game, which does cause us a little bit of a sad face. What's also going to cause us a bit of a sad face is it is the end of the casting for today. That's right, we'll be back again tomorrow. In fact, we'll be back here again in 14 hours from now. So this cast is going to go and rest. We'll be casting the Stars qualifying tournament, the second part of the group stages, as well as if there's any playoffs to do with that as well. And we'll be back here again for the defense tournament at 3 p.m. tomorrow. So if you want to tune in for that, you can do so at joindota.com. If you also want to check out 2@own3dtv, we have an events page up for the defense. You can actually watch all the live streams if you want to watch it in Russian. We won't have that option, I'm afraid. We'll have that option in the future. We do actually have the options for French as well as a secondary English stream. So if you want to check that out, please do so. In the meantime, thank you very much for actually tuning in. It's myself, Toby1, wishing you a very, very awesome weekend. I hope you're having a great weekend. Should do with more data action coming tomorrow. We'll see you then.